Polymers have become an integral part of our life. From toothbrush to large part of our car, all are made up of polymers. Overall, polymer industry is worth more than $1 trillion. What is the reason behind this amazing success? It is their unique properties. Polymers are lightweight, it can be easily molded into different shapes, and last but not the least, polymers are dirt cheap. So, it can be easily used for trash bag to aeroplane parts. Scientists have developed so many types of polymer that they vary in more ways than what unites them. This video will provide an overview on this amazing material which is called polymer and how do they differ from each other. What is a polymer? Polymers are materials whose basic unit is a long chain. So polymer differ from metal and chemical compound at fundamental level. Because of its long chain, polymeric materials show desired strength and flexibility. Although polymeric materials are not as strong as metal, but they show sufficient strength and much more flexibility than metal. Also, the strength and flexibility of polymer can be improved by adding different filler, a completely different topic for another video. However, ability of polymeric material to regain shape after deformation help it to get recognized for its first application, which is fabric. Humans are using natural polymers like silk and wool for thousands of years. Natural polymers show excellent strength and flexibility. But natural polymers are very costly because of their limited availability. Also, natural polymers cannot be melted and molded into different shapes. Discovery of chemical method to make man-made polymers, which are also called synthetic polymers, was a pivotal point in this amazing success story. As synthetic polymers can be industrially produced at large scale, it led to significant reduction in the cost of polymer. Nowadays, synthetic polymers are blended with natural polymer to achieve similar comfort at lower cost. Now, the question is how polymers are formed, both in nature and in an industrial reactor. In a very basic sense, polymers are made or formed by joining small molecules in a linear chain. These small molecules are called monomers. The process of making polymers from monomer is called polymerization. Based on reaction kinetics, polymerization reaction can be classified into addition polymerization and condensation polymerization. In addition polymerization, polymers are formed in three steps. In initiation step, a small number of monomers reacts with initiator molecules to form active monomer or free radical. In propagation step, the active monomer reacts with a large number of monomers through radical transfer and forms a long chain. And finally, in termination step, two active chains react with each other to form a neutral polymer chain. In condensation polymerization, monomers contains functional groups like acidic and basic groups which under appropriate condition react with each other and forms covalent bond between them. As reaction progresses, monomers forms dimer, trimer, tetramer and so on. Eventually, sufficient monomer reacts to form polymer chain. In a very general sense, we can say that a monomer which contains double bond can be polymerized by addition polymerization, and a monomer which contains functional group can be polymerized using condensation polymerization. For more detail about the reaction mechanism and merit and demerits of each mechanism, please watch our video on polymer synthesis. Anyways, during polymerization, reaction condition can be selected to achieve polymers with different molecular weight, which means polymer with different polymer chain length, and also we can change the composition and structure of the polymer chain. During polymerization, we can choose to use one or more types of monomer. If a polymer chain contains only one type of monomer, it is called homopolymer. And if a polymer chain contains two or more types of monomer, it is called copolymer. In case of copolymer, if monomers are arranged in an alternating sequence, it is called alternate copolymer. But if the monomers are randomly arranged in the polymer chain, it is called random copolymer. A polymer chain can also contain blocks of different monomers. Or a polymer chain can contain small segment of side chain. This type of polymer is called graft copolymer. Now the question is, why we would like to use different monomers in same chain? The answer is to achieve desired strength, flexibility, and flow. Properties of polymer strongly depends on the monomer type. Let's assume monomer A is a bulky monomer which form a strong polymer with limited flexibility, whereas monomer B is a small monomer and form polymer with excellent flexibility but poor strength. So if we want to have a material with good flexibility and strength, then we can design a polymer chain containing both A and B monomers. But we have to be careful, because if the size of A and B monomers are significantly different, we may lose the properties of both monomers. In order to keep properties of both monomers, we can design polymer chain containing blocks of A and B monomers. In industry, block length are precisely controlled to develop polymer with very specific properties. Properties of polymer also depends on orientation of side group. In the picture, we can see that side group of polystyrene polymer are oriented on one side of main chain. If side group of a polymer are oriented on one side of the main chain, it is called isotactic polymer. If the side groups are oriented in an alternating sequence, polymer is called syndiotactic polymer. And if side groups are randomly oriented, they are called atactic polymers. Based on the structure, we can say that isotactic and syndiotactic polymer chains are symmetric. Therefore, two isotactic or two syndiotactic polymer chains can come in close proximity and can form an ordered structure. Close proximity can also enhance the intermolecular interaction force. As a result, isotactic and syndiotactic polymers are usually very strong. As atactic polymer chains are asymmetric, two atactic polymer chains cannot come in close proximity. Therefore, atactic polymers are usually weak, but they show very high flexibility. Two types of microstructure are usually observed in polymer, namely amorphous and crystalline. In amorphous region, polymeric chains are randomly oriented, whereas in crystalline region, polymer chains form highly ordered structure. As I previously mentioned, isotactic and syndiotactic polymer chains can pack very well, so they form crystalline polymer. Whereas atactic polymer chains cannot pack, so they always form amorphous polymer. Typically, strength of polymer depends on the percentage crystallinity, and flexibility depends on amorphous content. A trivia: why a polymer can be 100% amorphous but not 100% crystalline? The answer is, end of polymer chain is physically and chemically very different than main chain. So chain ends cannot be a part of crystalline region, which prohibit polymers to to achieve 100% crystallinity. Based on intermolecular interaction, polymers can be classified as thermoplastics and thermoset. Thermoplastics contain neutral polymer chains, so they don't cross-link, and we can use these polymers multiple times. In case of thermoset, polymer chain contains reactive group, so during heating or under specific condition, they react to form cross-linked structure. As a result, thermosets cannot be reused. Because of high cross-link density, thermosets are extremely strong but brittle. So whenever high strength but low flexibility is required, thermosets are ideal choice. However, majority of polymers belong to the family of thermoplastic. So far, I discussed what is a polymer and how do they differ from each other. In my next video, I am going to discuss typical properties of polymer.